Well, today my conversation is with Jeremy Schifeling. He's the co-author of Linked, Conquer LinkedIn, Get the Job, Own Your Future. Thank you so much for talking with me here today.
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks for having me, Cam.
Oh my God, this is such a great book. It covers everything. Where do I start? I have so many questions. You led the education marketing efforts in LinkedIn, okay? You're a career coach, so you kind of have the inside scoop. What makes for the best profile that you could ever imagine?
Yeah, great question. And so it really comes back to understanding your audience. Who's on the other side of the screen? And there are recruiters all around the world who are searching LinkedIn every day, desperately trying to find great talent. And so a great profile doesn't necessarily mean that you have all-star level on LinkedIn, but it means that you meet your audience's needs. Number one, can they find you? Do you have all the right keywords in terms of the job title that you want and the skills that the recruiters are looking for listed on that profile? And number two, would they want to pick you? Do you have a nice smiling profile photo that says, hey, I am excited for opportunities, let's chat. If you can nail those two things, you're golden.
Right. So the keywords, there's why nobody's talking to me. And then I find out endorsements don't mean anything. I'm like working to get endorsements and endorsements don't mean anything.
Yeah. So the thing is that endorsements are a little bit too fluid. You know, back when endorsements first came out, my mom was endorsing me for everything from astronomy to zoology. And I knew nothing about either of those subjects. So they're not always the most credible thing. However, if you list out examples of your experience, like I've built a radio show from scratch to 100,000 listeners and I've right. achieved this level of success, that includes the keywords they're looking for, things like radio show or show development, and also the signifiers of success that show that you are really credible.
It's just, I mean, it's so much to learn, but like you, it's, I mean, it makes so much sense, right? Because you say, what is it, like 70% of resumes are now reviewed by a robot first to even see if you make it before human eyes?
Yeah. And again, put yourself in the recruiter's shoes. Everyone's applying for jobs left and right. It's the great resignation.
Yeah.
You don't want to read 1,000 resumes. You want to have the robots do what they're good at, which is scan really quickly, see do you have any of the sort of signals that you might be a good fit. And then I'll just apply my human eyes to the few resumes that actually seem like they qualify.
I dropped my notes. Give me a second. So here's the thing. Here's what I'm wondering about. Like for somebody like me who has done radio, TV, author, you know, all those things, like, how do you utilize all of those right now in, like, before it was always, I was just, you know, doing radio and now I've got all these different things and I'd like to be able to use all those different things.
Yeah, for sure. And I think that all those things are really critical because they're different channels for reaching your audience, right? And so LinkedIn is just another channel. And if your audience is recruiters or prospective listeners or advertisers, they're all on LinkedIn. There are 800 million professionals on there today.
Yeah.
And so by having the right keywords, by having the right strategy, you can make sure all those critical eyeballs are seeing you.
And how do you get the right keywords? For somebody that's watching right now and says, you know, I've got this stellar reputation. I have, you know, everything that people say that they're looking for, but nobody is finding me. What are the key, how do you even find out what keywords you should be using?
Yeah.
I mean, book talks about it, of course.
Of course. And definitely recommend that. But let me give your listeners a great hack for free, which if you go to a site called jobscan.co, you can paste in all the jobs you want. Ah, they're hiring over here and they're hiring over there. And it will scan through all that and tell you, these are the most important keywords. And here are the ones that you're lacking on your profile. And once you know that, you can start to reverse engineer it and build up your profile to match those keywords.
So smart. You know, and doesn't tell me if I'm right or wrong. Like it nowadays, maybe the most qualified person doesn't always get the job because they can't make it through the robotics.
Yeah, sad but true. It's really not about how qualified you are internally. It's about how you present externally. Brilliant. So do you come across as the perfect fit?
You are so sharp and you have courses. You do courses, right?
That's right. So we do a deep dive into how the algorithm works, how to get chosen on LinkedIn. And that's all on our website at thejobinsiders.com.
So you talked about the Great Resignation a little bit ago, and you help lots of young people coming out of college, graduates that are just trying to figure out how to navigate this whole thing. And then there's people that are maybe, I don't know, reinventing themselves. Is there a spot for them on LinkedIn as well?
Oh, absolutely. And in fact, in some ways, they're the best equipped because they've got that real experience. And so even if you want to change careers, LinkedIn is good for two things. Number one, you can reach out to insiders in your next career and learn about, hey, you went to University of Michigan or Michigan State just like me. Let's talk about what it's like to be in your space. And that's really powerful. And then number two, those people can refer you for jobs at their companies, which gives you a 10x advantage over people who only apply online.
Wow, that is amazing. And then people, what about people who maybe are tied into LinkedIn, but when they're communicating and they're trying to do what you're saying to do, there's not really a lot of interaction. And what about posting on LinkedIn? How important is posting, and then how do you get those people to see your post?
Yeah, so I think the trick with posting on LinkedIn is don't think of it like posting on Facebook or Twitter. No one cares what you ate for lunch. No one cares what you did this weekend. Your goal there is to get access to great opportunity. And that means two things. You've got to share valuable content. So maybe insights you've learned from your career in radio and TV that you can pass on.
Yeah.
And then you've got to make sure it reaches the right people. So can I tag others in the radio industry? Can I use hashtags like radio jobs to make sure that anyone who's in this space who really is the right audience is getting my message?
Oh my gosh, there's just so much. How old were you when all this, like when you got into all this craziness? Like you're an expert. How did you do it? Were you always into this?
So I have always been a big career nerd, to be honest. I've been fascinated by that black box of the hiring process. How does it work?
Yeah.
But I think the reality is, just like everyone out there, I struggled and applied online, got rejected over and over again. And I said, there's got to be a better way. And sure enough, there is.
And you wrote the book about it. Here's the big question. Doing all you did with LinkedIn, how important is it to pay the money to LinkedIn? Or just do the free ride? Does it matter?
Yeah. So this is why it's good that I don't work at LinkedIn anymore, because
I know I'm going to get a biased answer.
The party line before, but here's the reality. Everything we've just talked about, reaching out to people on LinkedIn, connecting with fellow alumni, getting that referral, getting access to those opportunities, all of that is completely free. And so there's no reason to pay LinkedIn, you know, $50 or $100 a month for LinkedIn Premium when the critical stuff is already at your fingertips.
Yeah. The stuff you get when you pay is to see who's spying on your profile, right?
That's right.
You got to figure out how much that's worth. How does the whole new job search thing work? Because I read a little bit about that in your book. And, you know, I really can't say, like, seriously, if you want to figure out how LinkedIn works, this is the only book you need. You cover everything. Like I read a little bit, then I had to go back and read it again, trying to figure it out, but you will master it if you get this. But what do you think?
Yeah.
How does the whole new job search thing work?
Yeah. And it's really about going from total chaos to total focus. You know, back when I started looking for jobs, I would apply on monster.com and indeed.com and just hope for the best.
Yeah.
And now you can be much more like a heat-seeking missile. You know, you go to LinkedIn, you identify the exact right path for you. You have set up automatic alerts, so you're notified whenever the best jobs in your space come available. And then you go in there and you get those jobs with a referral, so you don't have to be stuck on the outside just looking in.
And you even have a tip about referrals, where how you can get what's really important, not the people saying all those nice things about you. Are those recommendations?
Yeah, so recommendations are important.
How important are those?
Yeah, so think about it this way. If I'm a recruiter and I've got your resume in my hands, all I've got is your say-so. Kim's saying she's awesome, but can I trust Kim on the topic of Kim?
Right.
Might be a little biased there. Whereas recommendations are the rare chance for a recruiter to get third-party validation. Kim is absolutely as awesome as she says.
Good. And then you say that there's an algorithm that kind of prioritizes everything. What's at the very top?
Yeah, and this is really critical. So we've talked about keywords, but there's one place on your profile that matters more than any other, and that is your headline, that little piece of text right below your name. So on Kim's profile, it says, just a girl and her voice, radio, TV, podcast.
Oh, you spied on me.
I know, but I love it. And that's actually a really good headline, because think about this. If I'm searching for someone in radio or TV or podcasting, Kim's going to be on my radar because she's got those critical keywords in her most important section, her headline. And the reason it's most important is it's the shortest section on LinkedIn, 160 characters, which is shorter even than a tweet.
Yeah.
And therefore, you can't game it as well. And so it's the most authentic signal of who Kim really is.
I love that. That means so much. We're in a job market right now where it's a little different, right? Because people actually get to jump around and there's a plethora of jobs. How can we get in and use that with LinkedIn in the same way? And how important is local? Do you have to talk about that on your profile?
Yeah, such an interesting question, especially with the rise of remote work over the last couple of years. So I'm happy to say that on LinkedIn now, for the first time in the history of job boards, you can search not just for jobs down the street, but around the world. You can say, show me all the remote jobs in my industry.
Oh, wow.
And bam, you can work from anywhere.
I didn't even know that. And then you say there's a whole hidden job market.
Yeah. And that really refers to that power of relationships. You know, it's so funny. We've just been geeking out about technology and algorithms. Yeah. But at the end of the day, you know this, Kim, you're going to trust someone that you know or that your friends know more than a total stranger. And so if you have someone advocating for you who's part of your circle of trust, that's the person who's going to get that job. And so maybe you don't even list a job. Maybe you just go to your friends and say, who's the best person you know in the space? And so that's the hidden job market.
I love that. And then can you give me a tip on some of the hottest jobs right now?
Yeah. So for sure, there's a lot happening in the tech space around data, around programming. But honestly, there's a lot happening in every industry. Healthcare after the pandemic, finances with everything happening in real estate. And so on my last check, there were actually over 100,000 jobs in the Grand Rapids area and 7 million plus jobs across the country. So this is the time.
Oh my God. You're just so much fun to talk to. You are just amazing. You have 5 steps for success in this book. It will get you started. It's so easy to read. I can't say enough good things about it. And the thing is, there's diagrams in here too. Like, make yourself a local. You know, you've got diagrams, anything that you could ever possibly want to know about LinkedIn and how to get yourself right up there in the top. Where can people reach out to you?
So check us out at thejobinsiders.com. You can even get free coaching with us and we'll make your LinkedIn profile shine.
And the book is available at local bookstores and online everywhere. I'm geeked up about the book. Thank you so much for talking with me here today, Jeremy.
Thank you, Kim. And good luck to all your listeners.
Appreciate it.